Hi, I'm Nerys, and I've come to Live Lab today to do an experiment using some liver. So we're looking at a pig's liver here. This is actually quite similar to your own liver, slightly over onto the right-hand side, just about underneath where your ribs are. And it's actually the second largest organ in your body after your skin. When we look at the liver, it's kind of difficult to see what its function is, because a lot of what it does is down on a cellular level. One of the most important things is that it helps to get rid of toxins for us. For example, it gets rid of a chemical called hydrogen peroxide. So hydrogen peroxide is produced naturally by all of the cells of your body, but too much of it can be really bad for you. I've got some hydrogen peroxide here, and you can see it's got some warning labels on the bottle. So it's important for your body to break it down. And the liver has an enzyme called catalase in it, which helps to break down hydrogen peroxide into water and oxygen, much safer chemicals. The important thing about enzymes that we have in our body is actually they don't get used up in these reactions. So you could add more hydrogen peroxide to the same catalase, and it will continue to do the same process over and over again. So I'm going to mix some liver with some hydrogen peroxide, and we'll see if we can see a reaction happening. First thing we're going to do is cut off some of our liver to mix up with our hydrogen peroxide. And I'm actually going to cut this into smaller pieces, because the more surface area of liver we have, the more of the catalase we'll be exposing, so we'll get a better reaction. There we go, got our liver in there. And now I'm going to add some hydrogen peroxide. Oh wow, can you see all those bubbles? Those bubbles are the oxygen being produced by our reaction. Now I can show you that that really is oxygen by doing a test that chemists do to check for oxygen. So first I'm going to light a splint. So now I'm just going to blow it out so that it's just glowing. And now we're going to dip this into our oxygen, and if it really is oxygen, it should relight our splint. And there we go, our splint has relit, so there's definitely oxygen in there.
For more insides on the outside, check out our lung and brain dissections. Next week, we'll be investigating how things can glow in the dark. So for more science every week, click subscribe. Thanks for watching.